Hello everyone, and you've noticed I got a new light. My best friend Emily at Five Below got me this cool like camera light for my videos, so I know they looked a little dim before. So for this, my videos will be nice and bright. And Merry Christmas Eve. I hope everyone has a safe and happy Christmas, and I hope everyone is safe. And I know it's been a rough year, but for a lot of people, but I hope everyone just has a good day tomorrow. And I wanted to discuss this book. It's called Eat What You Want, a cookbook for movie lovers by Andrew Rea. And he's from the creator, he's the YouTube guy, Binging with Babish. And it takes food from movies, and he brings it like literally to life. You can create some of these recipes from movies, and I'm gonna read a little bit. This is dedicated to his mother. He dedicated this to his mother, and it talks about how food and movies are supposed to bring people comfort, and why not bring the two together, which I fully support. And it's like he says that food and movies is like a subtle like advertising for food, which I agree, because food, something like, if it's supposed to look beautiful, food and movies looks just absolutely divine. And here's some of, and it comes with this cool like bookmark. I don't know if everyone book comes with it, but I got this cute little bookmark, as it looks like a kind of like a vintage bookmark. And one of the entries here is 13 candles, or I'm sorry, 16 candles. And doesn't that just look so, just so beautiful? You just want to eat it. And it has a lot of cool like recipes, and Elf, the famous dessert pasta. I don't recommend eating that, but and it also has the butterbeer, and I first experienced butterbeer at Grad Bash at Universal. And it was very, very delicious. And I just think it's so cool, because, oh, and My Cousin Vinny, I love this movie. I just think it's so cool that bringing, like, two, because food in itself, like, is, like, art. It brings joy to people, and it connects people, and so do movies. So I love that. That like this was thought of. And then the cheese pool souffle from Sabrina, I just love that so much. And the photos in here are fantastic. And then the Breakfast at Tiffany's, one of my favorite movies. Chicken mole with saffron rice.
Do you think it's trying to tell us something?
I hope you like chicken and saffron rice served with chocolate sauce. It's an East Indian classic, my dear.
3 months ago, I couldn't scramble eggs.
That's just so amazing. I just love the photos in here. And some of it ranges from, like, oh, you can do it, like, in 30 minutes. And some of it, like, takes weeks, some of the recipes. And then the Ratatouille, which that movie, I think, showcases how beautiful, like, film food in itself could be. Like in a film. And then there's just so many. And Pretty Woman, I just talked about that. Now this, I feel like, I believe it's escargots and garlic butter. Yeah, this would be, I believe, kind of difficult to make, but it's still cool. That's super cool. Wow. And then there's a few more I wanted to discuss. Oh, Roman Holiday, hazelnut gelato. That sounds absolutely yummy. And I was thinking about, like, trying one of these recipes out and making it into a video. I think that would be really fun. And When Harry Met Sally, the famous deli scene, the food, New York style pastrami. And this one, I was reading the expert, when you dine at Manhattan Cat's delicacy, I can't say the word, you see a wooden place card commemorating the spot where Meg Ryan convinced Billy Crystal that he had never, in fact, pleased a woman. You can also order a steaming mountain of impeccably cured smoked and spice smoked and steamed beef brisket, otherwise known as pastrami. So I think this takes a bit. If you don't know, if you don't happen to be on the Lower East Side, here's how you can enjoy the New York style pastrami at home. As long as you have a smoker, some curing salts, and are willing to wait a couple weeks. Serve it on a giant slab of toasted rye bread, which is so good, with a generous smear of spicy mustard, and let your toes curl if you're moved. Well, so that's freaking amazing.
Sure.
Well, explain to me how you do it. What do you say?
Just have an early meeting, early haircut, early squash game.
You don't play squash.
They don't know that. They just met me.
That's disgusting.
I know. I feel terrible.
That's so freaking cool. This book is, I believe she got it off Amazon. Ooh, with the beautiful moonlight. Look at that photo. That is freaking amazing. Pollo a la Blanchon. That's, I'm sorry for that horrible Spanish. Moonlight is a story of a young man's struggle growing up gay in one of Miami's roughest neighborhoods. The movie also happens to capitalize on the vibrancy of the city's local Latin cuisine, which I agree, it's so freaking beautiful. Using food as a metaphor for care and genuine intimacy. And food can mean symbolism as well. And I just love this. And I've always, it's so funny because when Kevin made that Moonlight, I wanted to eat it. So that's freaking cool that he got that. And Whiplash, which is also a great movie. Popcorn with chocolate covered raisins, which I think that's freaking, so it ranges from easy to like kind of hard. Yeah, and then Beetlejuice. But this book is so cool. Eat What You Watch. This is such an amazing read. It's very interesting. The photos are just vibrant. And it's, I just love it so much. It's one of my favorite gifts I've ever gotten. So thank you, Emily. My best friend got it for me. And and this is really interesting. And I plan on doing some of the recipes from here. I hope everyone has a lovely Christmas and happy holidays.